and welcome to We the People. If you are tired of the blanket coverage of the Maha mess in Maharashtra, then you're in the right place. Let's take a break from all of that for an hour and let's focus on another story that also made headlines this week. On Wednesday, the Rajya Sabha deferred the Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019, which seeks to ban commercial surrogacy in India after several members wanted modifications to it. The proposed legislation, which was moved by the Health Minister, Dr. Harsh Vardhan, in the Upper House on Tuesday, was passed by the Lok Sabha in the Monsoon session. Now, among its other highlights, the bill only allows a close relative to act as a surrogate to couples who have been legally married for at least 5 years. Now, according to the government, this bill is aimed at checking unethical practices, the exploitation of surrogate mothers, the abandonment of children born out of surrogacy and rackets around intermediaries who import human embryos and gametes. But we're asking tonight, is this protecting rights or denying choice? Is the Surrogacy Bill 2019 unfair to women by limiting their options? On the show tonight, we have Shamina Shafiq, a former member of the National Commission for Women, a political and social activist working in the field of women's empowerment and children's education. We have Lalita Kumaramangalam, former chairperson of the National Commission for Women, the current member of the BJP. We have Dr. Sheela Saravanan. She's an author of A Transactional Feminist View of Surrogacy Biomarkets in India. We have Tannishtha Chatterjee, actor. You know her for her roles in films like Brick Lane, Parched, Angry Indian Goddesses and others. She's a mother now via the adoption route. We have Mamata Kale here from the BJP, from the Congress. We have Rajya Sabha MP from Karnataka, MV Rajiv Gowda. Dr. Shivani Sachdev Gaur, she is a founder and director of the SCI Healthcare. It's the largest, one of the largest and most experienced IVF providers in India. She's also General Secretary of the Indian Society for Third Party Assisted Reproduction. And we have Mr. KTS Tulsi, senior advocate in the Supreme Court and Rajya Sabha member, joining us today. I want to start with Dr. Sheela Saravanan. Your research in this book that you've written took you brought you face to face with at least 45 surrogate mothers and their families. What did you find? Because is there really this dark underbelly to the surrogacy industry in India as those who are pushing this bill claim?
Yeah, I did two sets of studies. One I did in 2009 and 10. That was, I followed several surrogate mothers throughout their surrogacy. And I did another study in this year, February 2019.
And what did you find?
And my main findings were that there was a lot of violations of human rights. There were several unethical practices. Sex-selective abortions, in utero selective abortions were being done. And based on sex, the selection of women based on their, caste, class, and looks, and the weight of their body, the fatter women were preferred in surrogacy, and caste, they were paid more. And it also added on to many of my previous, I didn't know that sex selection abortions were being done, but this time I got to know that it was very much being done. And surrogate mothers were basically being used as, as just bodies for money making. And I say money making because many of these clinics, they kind of, I know there's one big clinic in Western Gujarat, Western India, I don't want to mention the name. But when the it was, mushrooming and the practice was really growing in India, they actually grew into this huge, big complex, which looked like a mall where you had everything inside. You had a surrogate, the surrogate home, and the surrogate home was shifted to the underground. So you can imagine what was building up. So the earlier surrogate mothers could at least come out into the courtyard. They could buy samosas but because they are diet
they were
was
kept
restricted
there for 9 months, 10 months. They were just kept
so
there.
So their diet was restricted. But now they were underground. So but suddenly
Doctor,
the bill came
Doctor
up.
Dr. Saravanan, the logical question that would lead me to ask is, if I were using someone as a surrogate, isn't it in my own interest to make sure she gets sunlight, she gets exercise, she gets food?
I think this I and she, because this is, it's not about her getting food. Okay, she might get food, but it's about her choice about what food she wants. It's about her choice about whether she wants the selective abortions or not, whether she wants how many embryos. If doctors want only two children, if they want only twins, implant two embryos. Don't put three embryos and then do a selective abortions and the whole, it's a risk-taking process. And
okay,
many
Dr. Shivani Gaur, this is an industry that reeks of exploitation. It's reeking of misuse, and surrogates are being coerced by husbands. They're being coerced by pimps. And as ma'am put it over here, she says they're just being used as bodies, they're vessels. Please respond, because you're a representative, you're one of the leading members of this industry that Parliament claims is all of these things.
When you write a book, the title of which is commodity, it means that you look at the baby as a commodity. No parent who does surrogacy, neither a surrogate mother, no clinic looks at it as a commodity. It is a child. It is a living and a breathing child. And as per United Nations, every couple has a right to have their baby, to found a family. Now, when it comes to surrogate mothers, you say exploitation. What is exploitation? Define it. If a woman who is of a lower socioeconomic class, can she ever have a choice? Can she ever have freedom? And if she decides that, according to me, if I do surrogacy, I get a certain amount of money, with this I want to do a project. And everybody tells her, no, that is not right, because you cannot choose. You are not allowed to choose, and forever you are exploited. See, if you are talking about problems, there are problems in every kind of field that we look at. So you will have 1-2% cases where every field there are problems. But
so
it
then
doesn't
would you at
mean,
least say there is a need for regulation? There's some need. The government is on the right track.
Sarah,
that
our whole
some things
society,
are wrong, it needs
exactly,
to step in.
See, our whole society wants a regulation and a law, and the reason for that is because people keep saying, oh, this is not legal, not legal. Once and for all, once there is a law, the whole process will become legal. Everything will become streamlined. That is what we hope for. But unfortunately, when the current law comes in, 99.9% of the people are not going to be able to access this, are not going to be able to do it. So either they are going to move abroad, where they will be able to do, because
those
people
who can afford it.
People are not going to abandon their dream or their choice of having a family. That is not something people do.
So they will find a way, whether it's under the table or whether it's spending more money and going abroad to countries like Georgia, etc., which are stepping up to the plate.
Yes, because the women who are
But respond to, you know, what Dr. Saravanan has mentioned, and I think the journalist Julie Bendel in The Guardian had said, she said it's common practice to plant embryos in two or more surrogates, perform abortions if more than one pregnancy
See,
takes
that
place.
Is, that shows the level of knowledge about IVF. In IVF, I wish it was like that you put two and you get two. That is not IVF. That is not IVF anywhere in the world.
More than one pregnancy, planting in two separate women. And then one takes, so you abort the other. Things like that. They're talking about those examples.
I think the standard practice is IVF technology, and it is a standard practice all over the country. It is in international practice, and in general, when the embryos are transferred in our country, it is two or three, which is the standard number.
But you're saying there are some bad apples. There's always a bad apple everywhere. But you have in the past said that the surrogacy bill has been moved without consulting surrogates. Is that true?
Yes, because it was the surrogate mothers. There was an article in Times of India. Surrogate mothers had gone to the ICMR, National Commission of Women. But I think the first time that they were consulted was during this joint parliamentary committee, when actually multiple surrogate mothers were called and they actually said whatever they had to say. And based on that, the committee made recommendations. They said that for surrogate mothers, they find that the current job they are doing is exploitative. Surrogacy is not any more or any less. In fact, it might be even less exploitative than what they are doing right now. And you should not have a paternalistic attitude and not take them for granted.
Okay, so you can't throw out the baby with the bathwater. You should regulate, don't ban. Parliament hasn't consulted with surrogates. I don't want to be accused of doing the same. So we actually have one joining us tonight. We have Ganga. Aap yahan pe aaye ho. Thank you so much, Ganga ji. Aap surrogate mother ho. Aap abhi pregnant ho?
Haan ji, do mahine ki.
Do mahine ki. Achha, to aapke paas bache already hai?
Hai, do hai.
Kitne hai?
दो बच्चे हैं
तो और ये पहली बार आप कर रहे हो
पहली बार कर रही
हूं तो आप क्यों कर रहे हो गंगा जी
ये मैं करने के लिए मेरा जो घर में तकलीफ है घर है नहीं है घर बनाने के लिए वो मेरे को जो जितना पैसा मिलेगा उससे लिए मैं खुद मेरा पति मैं दोनों मिलके सलाह करके एक कर रही हूं
बट आपकी फैमिली ने क्या बोला मतलब सास एक्सटेंडेड फैमिली आपके पति तो एग्रीमेंट में है
हां सब सपोर्ट अभी बच्चे का फ्यूचर भी करना है ना
हां
बच्चे के लिए भी तो कर सकते हैं। अभी आदमी के घर में काम करने के लिए 5,000 देगा, 10,000 देगा, खा के ही खत्म हो जाएगा ना, वो पैसा से कुछ करने नहीं सकेंगे।
तो और एक कर रहे हैं ना,
एक कर रहे हैं इसमें तो हम लोग का जितना जमा पैसा देगा मेरा एक घर भी बन जाएगा, एक दुकान भी बन जाएगा।
आपको पैसा कितना मिलेगा?
पैसा 3 लाख मिल जाएगा मेरे को।
अच्छा, और आप लोगों को क्या कहोगे, आपके मतलब नेबर पड़ोसी एक्सेट्रा, जब आप डिलीवरी के लिए जाओगे और फिर वापस आओगे?
लोगों को मेरे को कोई लोगों के लिए मतलब नहीं है, मेरा जो घर चलेगा संसार चलेगा मैं वही देखूंगी। जो मैं सच्चा ईमानदारी से काम कर रही हूँ, मैं कुछ गलत काम नहीं कर रही हूँ। जो मेरा पति मेरे साथ दिया है उसी के वजह से मैं कर रही हूँ। एक चीज कोई गलत नहीं है, हफ्ता हफ्ता में हम लोग को चेकअप करती है, डॉक्टर दिखाती है, और खाने में पैसा देती है, कपड़ा देती है। और जो मैं आदमी के घर में काम करूंगी तो मेरे को 5,000 देगी, 10,000 देगी, मेरे खाना बच्चे को खाना खिला के खत्म हो जाएगी, मैं कुछ करने नहीं सकूंगी। उसीलिए मैं एक काम करने के लिए मजबूर हूँ,
सोच समझ के ये डिसीजन लिया। गंगा जी देखिए, ये सरकार हमारी सरकार अभी कह रही है कि इसको जो आप कर रहे हो अभी उनको बैन करना चाहिए, और एक्चुअली जो आप अभी कह रहे हो आप 2 महीने के जो प्रेग्नेंट हो, क्योंकि सरकार ने ऑलरेडी लोकसभा में इसको डिस्कस करके पास की है, अब राज्यसभा में होना है, 9 महीने में हो भी सकता है, तो फिर जो आप कर रहे हो इलीगल हो जाएगी अगर प्रेसिडेंट उसको गो हेड देगी। आपने ये सब सोचा? आपको आप अवेयर हो कि सरकार कह रही है कि ये मतलब गंदी चीज है, नहीं होना चाहिए?
ये तो गंदी चीज नहीं है, हम लोग गरीब के लिए सही चीज है। हम लोग को आदमी पैसा नहीं देगी ना, ऐसे चेहरा देख के भी नहीं देगी, काम करना पड़ेगा। उसके बाद आपको तो पता है जगह जगह में काम करने से कैसे गलत भी हो जाती है, उल्टा सीधा भी हो जाती है। अभी वो इसमें जो हम लोग रहते हैं इसमें हम लोग का हर जिम्मेदारी वो लोग उठाती है, हम लोग को खाना देती है, कमरा देती है, हर हफ्ता में चेकअप करती है, बहुत कुछ फैसिलिटी मिलती है।
Mamta, here you have a woman who is taking control. She wants to take control over her own life. She wants to take control over her future. She wants to look after her kids. What is so wrong in that? Why is the government saying that this should be taken away from her?
Sarah, I am all for this bill. Not, you know, because I happen to be a woman first and then a member of BJP, to be very honest. And I seriously, genuinely want this bill to be passed in the upper house,
because but in the because, form that because, it is saying that what Ganga is doing is wrong. Ganga will not be able to do this. You may be supporting this bill. This bill says that what Ganga is doing, commercial surrogacy, is bad.
Yeah, so I'm coming to that. There are lot of women, there are lot of families who actually force the ladies of their houses who come from economically weaker sections, or from other families who come from below the poverty line. They kind of, you know, force the women to get into this surrogacy, because for the family it is a easy money, it is quick bucks, Arad. Rest of the family members doesn't have to do anything. They don't even understand, realize that a lady, when she goes through the whole process, actually, you know, she is being tortured physically as well as emotionally also. So this is another part of it. So it has actually become a mean to earn money. So a woman is not a commodity, you know. You really cannot force her to rent her womb or sell her body against her will, and this happens here. So obviously this bill is required, because exploitation is not acceptable to any one of us, for that matter. You are also a woman, I am a woman, we all understand that this cannot happen. In fact there are a lot of European countries who have prohibited surrogacy, be it Germany, Italy, or rest of the countries. Even in US, in UK, and in some states of US, they have also made it very clear that when a woman is going through this surrogacy, she is a surrogate mother, only expenses which she would be getting would be pertaining her pregnancy expenses. Mm. So obviously there are reasons, because women are being exploited.
How desperate must a woman really be to carry a child for money? But the argument here is that the government is taking away a source of livelihood of these women without providing them an alternative. She's saying she wants all she wants is a home over her head. She wants to start a shop. This is what everybody dreams of. The government can't provide that. Prices are going up. The economy is slowing. Why are they taking this away from them?
I don't think the government can take away the livelihood of a person. This is one of the means of earning livelihood. It's better than starving. It's better than having to sell your children to be able to buy food grain for being able to survive. Otherwise, they have the only other option is die. It's not only that they are being forced. They are being forced for so many things. Are the poor women not being forced even to indulge in prostitution? Are they not being forced to do menial jobs? Are they not being forced to compromise? You see, poverty is the greatest sin. It's the greatest crime. And just because they are poor, we can't take away their livelihood. You are providing them nothing. And on the other hand, they have the normal option, averages 4 to 12 lakh they can earn. They can build a house. They can marry a child. The mother won't sell her child for 2,000, 4,000 rupees, which is regularly happening in close proximity of Delhi, in Haryana. Mm. Particularly, girls are being sold. Boys are being sold.
Okay, so, but you agree there is need for regulation?
Regulation, of course. The mothers should get registered. The surrogates should be required to get registered. Their agreements copies should be available in the registry. The payment should be ensured on time. They should be conditions laid down in which the surrogate to which surrogate
Correct.
Is entitled.
So there is need for regulation. That much everybody agrees on.
I'm saying that regulation. We regulate workmen's compensation. We regulate workmen's wages, minimum wages. We ensure that this is the minimum wage. You must be. Similarly, you can regulate. This is an industry. This
so
could
this,
become an industry.
Be
$400 million.
Have the same. Okay.
$400 million. I mean, we have such acute poverty. What are we talking about? Comparing ourselves with Western nations?
Mamta, go ahead.
No, Sarah, I'm speaking from a woman's point of view. You know, it is very easy to sell your knowledge. Yes, if I have some knowledge that is by intellectual property, I can sell it. But selling, forcing someone and asking someone to sell her body, a woman's body, or asking her to rent one part of her body is a completely different thing. We actually cannot compare selling your intellectual property and your body into same this thing. I'm sorry, sir, that cannot happen. You know, and poverty is, because of the poverty, this has actually become an industry which is not regularized, and government has to step into this to be able to help the women.
We are able to stomach women, humans, you know, scavenging, all of that is okay by us, but a woman selling her body and selling her womb for to somebody else, that is something which is not a sanskari
novice.
But hold on, I want to get in
Shamina
Shafiq.
Secondly, you know, the women are being paraded. They are being chosen. That if she is good looking, she comes from
people
a
are
good family.
Pressurizing them to do this, Mamta, one second. But this bill.
Secondly, I agree that adoption is a very good option.
All fashion shows are parading.
Okay, get to adoption, Mr. Tulsi. One second, let me get Shamina Shafiq in. The government says this bill has been brought in order to stop the exploitation of surrogate mothers. But in the current form, when we talk specifically about altruistic surrogacy only, are we going to then, is there a fear, is there a worry that we will actually end up exploiting them more, or you'll just change the exploiter will go from being, you know, the husband or a pimp to being maybe a sister-in-law or a mother-in-law?
I'm worried because the entire discussion as of now is happening only from the point of view of a surrogate mother. What about a woman who actually wants to bear a child but is unable to bear a child? And she's subjected to all forms of violence in her home because she's unable to bear a child. There's a lot of social taboo stigma to that also. We are not even talking about her interests, the interests of the father also, not just the mother. Now, first of all, every bill or any practice that has been happening in the country, for example, surrogacy, definitely it needs some kind of regulation. I'm all for regulation. But regulation only because you feel that the woman, because she's poor, she doesn't have the right to choose what is right and what is wrong for her. Mm. I mean, that is something which is very, very patriarchal. Also, first of all, for example, I am a relative of a woman who is unable to bear a child. Mm. That means my in-laws are going to force me to get into that surrogacy. I have to be forced to become a surrogate mother because I am a part of the family. Yeah. Then the exploitation, because it is within the four walls of the house, you're okay with it. you're absolutely fine because it is happening within the four walls of the house. It should not happen outside, as long as I am getting economically empowered and socially empowered, because I have the right to choose and decide for myself, you have a problem. The second thing, and the most important thing, is that here, when a relative is forced to become a surrogate mother,
yeah,
and obviously the family knows who's the surrogate mother and who's going to actually have the child. Later on, property issues are going to be there. There are multiple issues that are going to happen.
Also, who's the
going
child, to, when the child, yes, grows up, the is child, there an the attachment trauma, problem, the emotional trauma.
Nobody is talking about that. Actually, the problem of the present bill is that you can do anything as long as it is brushed aside, I mean, under the carpet, inside the four walls of the house, it's absolutely fine. You can actually do whatever you feel like with women.
Any amount of
but no, again, yes, has yes, this yes, been thought through in this bill? Women. Altruistic surrogacy has its own problems.
Yes, and see, she's actually denying herself, because when she talks about within the family, she's yeah. saying, I'm forced to do surrogacy yeah. for another sister-in-law.
Yeah.
But when it comes to forcing...
Please ask her, is she forced?
No. Let me finish yeah. my point. See, we are not, let us look at the picture. We are not looking at, we are looking at women who are poor, women who are not literate, who are not capable of getting an employment. So these women are put up, there's a particular option. Let me finish. Yeah. So there's an option put in front of them saying that here, this is an option. You have the onus now to bring this family out of poverty. And first, surrogacy is, it's not always one surrogacy means one trial. We have to remember there are two or three trials for one surrogacy. There is enough evidence, scientific evidence, that surrogate pregnancy has higher, is higher risk.
May I
it's a high risk
now?
Pregnancy.
The trial is not going to happen in the relative.
Finish,
there
is a high risk pregnancy. And we are talking about, okay, one surrogacy, they already know that there are three surrogacies it takes for a woman to bring her family completely out of poverty, poor women. So I have seen in many of my case studies that women, one surrogacy, they go back home, okay, 1 year, you had your relaxed time, now go again.
It's now, better, second surrogacy, it's better than having you go to back sell your home. Organs.
So it's limited to two.
This is, I mean, this is okay. saying that women are, you know, either
this
or that.
But the same questions you raise, I can undergo that all
But the
trauma.
Same issues that
I
you
mean,
raise,
ma'am, right.
would also hold if it's a relative. It's all a woman right. who's doing yeah, it, exactly. undergoing the process, whether it's a relative or absolutely. Someone complete stranger who's a poor or
But that doesn't make
a choice
as a relative.
It's not a choice.
It's a choice. And this is her choice. It's Ganga's choice. Ganga ne apne aap choose kiya. There's so many angles, so many issues, so many layers to this. It's so hard to get to it all. We only have about half an hour left. But I want to touch upon one issue that you mentioned, Shamina Shafiq. You said that, you know, what about the mother? Maybe she, someone who is unable to have a child, and she really wants a child. That's her, you know, her dream, her goal, her desire. What about her? Why are we taking this away from her? But I want to ask, this bill in its current form says, yes, if there's a mother like that, her she should be, you know, her desire should be met. But what about same-sex couples? If they have the same desire, no. What about people who are in live-in relationships? What about single moms? We have one joining us, Tannishtha Chatterjee. Thank you so much. You are a single mom. I'll get to that first. But you've recently become a mom and you've taken the adoption route. What would you say to those who argue that they want to ban commercial surrogacy? It should be banned because that will then lead to people adopting more. And that's what we need, because we have so many abandoned children or babies in India. Your thoughts.
Yes, actually, my personal thought, I've been listening to the debate. Of course, there's a side to, you know, the employment factor of it, that there are a lot of poor women whose livelihoods are becoming surrogates. So I'm not a specialist on the surrogate bill, and I'm also learning things, like, you know. But from an emotional perspective and an individual perspective, I would say that I have always felt from a very young age, especially growing up in India, that you know, there are too many children who are orphaned or abandoned at any given point of time. Now there are around 20 to 30 million children who are orphaned or abandoned. And so I think it would encourage a lot of couples and individuals to take the adoption route, which I don't think necessarily is a bad thing, given, you know, the state of the kind of, you know, cities that we have, which are really not children friendly. We are really suffocating all our big cities. Environmentally, we are a disaster. So I personally, but it's a very personal take, right? I do not understand why would you want biological children. But having said all that, I just feel that the choice whether to have a biological child or not is very, very individual. Yeah. That's my personal reaction to the environment that I live in, and therefore I chose to adopt. And even if I had a choice of surrogacy, I opted, you know, against surrogacy because, you know, my child came to me the beginning of this year, and I applied through CARA 2 years back. So I could have gone through surrogacy as well, but that was something that I was very clear about, that I do not want to have a biological child.
But let me ask you, you know, how easy or difficult was the process of adoption? Because those who are advocates of this bill, they're saying that those who say that there should be commercial surrogacy, they say that the adoption rules are very stringent. So they would have gone for that, but right now the government has made it impossible, and so they're doing surrogacy. What was your experience
Actually, when it came to adopting a child? I have gone through this process. I think it's very simple if you follow the rules. And I have to say that my personal experience with CARA and the adoption home that I adopted my child from has been extremely smooth. It's just that, yeah, you need to have your paperwork and the process, which I think is due diligence. It should be done exactly the way that it is done. The home study is done properly. Your background checks, your verification, everything has to be done so that one is sure that, and the government is sure, and the homes are sure that the child is going to a safe home. But I think if you follow the process, I'm a single mom. And
yes, I was going to ask you, what role did that play? Was it harder? Because I know you said that you didn't look into surrogacy, the option of surrogacy. But if you had, under this bill, and if this bill goes through, you are not eligible to have a child via surrogacy, where basically what this bill is saying that as a single mom is not able to look after a child as a mother who's married.
I think, of course, the bill should not be discriminatory. If it is saying that commercial surrogacy would be banned, but you can have surrogacy within close relatives, but that is something that needs to be defined more clearly, what is close relative. And I think it should not be discriminatory. It should be inclusive of all kinds of people who want to, have the possibility of going through surrogacy. I feel that yes, it should not be discriminatory, because like for me as a single mom, if the process of adoption was discriminatory, I would have felt really why am I not allowed? And in fact, the adoption process favors single moms to adopt like girl child. So why should the surrogacy bill be discriminatory here? So that is something that I don't kind of agree. But having said that, commercial surrogacy, whether it should exist or not, I feel like in a country like India, I mean, of course, there are many aspects, and I'm actually not a specialist to comment on various things, but this is just a very individual feeling. I feel more and more parents, more and more individuals should opt for adoption, because there are a lot of orphaned and abandoned kids in our country.
All right. Thank you, Tannishtha, and congratulations on your new baby. But an important point, this bill should not be discriminatory, says Tannishtha Chatterjee. Lalita Kumaramangalam, according to this bill, if it goes through, overseas Indians, foreigners, unmarried couples, single parents, live-in partners, gay couples, they will all be barred from commissioning the services of surrogate mothers. Would it not then be also dashing the hopes of millions of couples, as well as unmarried singles, LGBT persons, divorcees either? You've been a single mom yourself.
Yes, for many years. Before I get into answering directly what you've asked, let me make a couple of points that we seem to have forgotten in this whole debate. One is that women in India, especially poorer women or women from orthodox families, which are most families in India even today, are under tremendous pressure to become mothers. Today, young educated girls who have incomes of their own are choosing very often not to be mothers, much like what Ms. Chatterjee had said. And the fact is that when we talk about choice, whether it's informed choice or not is a big question mark. That itself is a very gray area in many fields of work, including sex work, etc. Now, I have worked for many, many years with sex works, with sex workers, with LGBT, with single mothers, with widows, etc., abandoned women, etc. And I have seen that basically they are considered as commodities. Now, while I may per se not have anything against surrogacy, this whole Indian obsession about having one's own child is, I think, personally ridiculous. But now, many people will not agree with me. They will say that I sound too, many.
This is no way to make people change their
minds. I think that along with banning foreigners, to answer one of the questions you asked, banning foreigners, etc., I feel is quite right. Because only the only people who come to India from other countries are countries or states where surrogacy has been banned, for whatever reason that may be.
And just as rich Indians will now go to other states if surrogacy is banned here, they'll be going to other countries.
Sorry?
Just as many would argue that...
We can't really prevent them from going up to other countries. But I'm concerned about my own country. I'm not concerned about what's going on in Georgia or somewhere else. Perhaps I'll sound a little simplistic and callous. But that's how I feel. May I please finish?
Go ahead, ma'am.
I'll finish soon now. The other thing is that while I agree that women must have a choice, the choice should not be to be forced to sell one's wombs to support one's own family. The longer term and the better choice is to see that women get the education they deserve, that they have a choice in their reproductive health and their own reproduction itself. Most women in India don't have that choice. Sex selection is rampant in India, despite there being a very strong law against it. And I'm sorry to sound so critical of many doctors, but most of us don't know what's really going on in these labs where surrogacy is taking place. I'm hearing of not just sex selection, I'm hearing of gene slicing, I'm hearing of splicing, I'm hearing many other things which we don't even know about. None of us are really scientists or doctors to that extent that we know about. Now, poor women must have a choice, yes, but the choice should not be that they sell one part or the other of their body. Neither is sex work to be recommended, nor should surrogacy be recommended as a work of choice for poor women. That's what I'd like to say. The bill, in any case, has been referred to a select committee, and I think all the objections and the changes that are being asked for will be discussed in great detail.
But every parent has to, let me get back to my original question. Here. Every parent has a right to want a child and have a child if they want. Why keep out, anyone who's homosexual, anyone who's single, anyone who's under a certain age? Why is the government trying to make a bill that is discriminatory against some Indians?
I agree to that, but the fact is that, as Ms. Chatterjee said, there are millions of abandoned babies in this country. Unfortunately, most of them are girls, and you know what a bias there is against girls even today in this country, and that is one of the major reasons, though most people will never admit it in public. That's one of the major reasons why people don't want to go for adoption. In fact, in adoption today, the system is streamlined, totally transparent, and there's no bias against anybody. Anybody can adopt, regardless. Now, insofar as gay couples are concerned, regardless of whether they're lesbians or bisexual or whatever it is, I have nothing against any of them. I have too many friends from amongst those communities to have any bias against them. But the fact is that most of these do have a choice to adopt. I'm sorry if I sound callous, but the fact is that we need to put also the greater good, especially of these children who are abandoned, who are sold, who are just because they're girls most of the time. They're beautiful children. The number of friends I have who are from many different communities who've adopted children and are very, very happy with them. I think India needs to have a real change in their attitude. The question of choice to women shouldn't be between poverty and selling your body for one thing or the other. That's something that I feel very strongly about.
But then
about.
Maybe the government needs to work on the economy more instead of trying to push through these bills.
70-plus couple have a couple of children
okay,
through
let's
surrogacy.
Get Dr. Gaur, really please come in over here. Please respond to what Ma'am Kumara Mangalam has said.
I don't feel that attacking surrogacy is going to promote adoption in any way at all. It is a basic human right. Mm-hmm. I can choose how I want to found a family. And adoption as a process please try and understand what is the problem in adoption. It is bureaucratic, it causes problems. If you streamline those problems, that will promote adoption. By attacking 5,000 couples in a year who are going to opt for surrogacy, how is that going to benefit, to be forced and pushed towards surrogacy? How is that going to benefit the child or the couple in any way? It just doesn't happen. And with due respect to ma'am who talks about gene splicing, etc., this is all very hi-fi research, and really it's not something that I can put under my table and just do something like that. These are kind of things which maybe they are being done somewhere abroad, but just to throw around these words and to tag surrogacy with them, why is surrogacy, I mean, it's completely illogical to tag these two things together. So I'm really sorry that I would not agree that all those points are relevant to surrogacy. Please look at surrogacy as an option for a woman who wants to have her own baby, a child.
Okay, I want to, before we take this further, go bring in Sumati from Chennai, who is also a surrogate mom. She only speaks Tamil, so I just spoke with her a short while ago, and here's what I asked her. Sumati, basically, I asked her first, why did you agree to this? Listen to her answer.
I live in Chennai's Vyasarpadi. I have four kids and my husband is an auto driver, but he doesn't make enough money. Our family was reeling under debt. This agent told us that you can make money by donating eggs. He said that people paid up to 2 lakh rupees for this. I asked him about the procedure. He said that I can make money by keeping the fertilized egg in my uterus for people who are infertile. My family stopped me from doing this, but I still went to the hospital. There I saw a lot of young women who were not able to give birth. They were all in their early 30s. I wasn't ready to donate eggs initially, but I went there to take a look inside the hospital. One woman approached me and said that her in-laws taunt her for not being able to give birth. She said that they were thinking of getting her husband remarried. She said, had I given birth to a child, I would not need to listen to these harsh words. I felt really bad for her and explained this to my husband. I said that I don't have to do anything, I just have to take the fertilized egg from the couple, which will be placed inside my uterus through a syringe. After explaining all this to my kids and my husband, they agreed.
All right, so you went ahead with the process, and what was your experience?
They promised us 2 lakh rupees. They gave me an agreement, but I don't know how to read and write. So my husband signed the agreement. The couple had spoken to the agent and they had agreed on 2 lakh rupees as compensation. But in the end, I was only given 1.5 lakh rupees. They gave no reasons for not giving the remaining amount. When I asked about the money, the agent kept on delaying, and I never got to see that money. The hospital took good care of me initially when I was pregnant, but after delivering the baby, they started behaving in a strange manner.
And will you do it? I last asked Sumati whether she would do this again. Sumati, will you do this again? The government is now wanting to push forward a bill that will ban commercial surrogacy, ban what has happened with you. But would you do this again if given a chance?
But even now, if someone requests me to carry a baby for them, I would still do it. I know the difficulties a family faces and what is said to a woman when she cannot give birth to a child. People end up getting divorced. Some women end up killing themselves. Even if there is a shortcoming in the man, the woman only is blamed. I'm not doing it for money, but if someone asks me to do it for free, I would still not mind doing it again. This is a wrong decision by the government to ban this. Basically, the rich are getting richer, the poor are getting poorer. We are getting a chance to make money. There is so much inflation. What are my other options?
Shamina Safiq, the rich are getting richer, the poor are getting poorer. The government can only the poor will be affected. The rich will continue to live their lives unaffected.
I hate to say this, but this is the harsh reality of India today, and nobody seemed to be working on it. Just now the example was given that there are XYZ countries, I mean UK and blah blah blah, that it's been banned. Look at the social security that people are getting there. look at the kind of education that people are promised and they receive there. I mean, you are not trying to match up to those social securities that the citizens in UK or in US
but
or for
you want
that
to
matter,
match them when it
but
comes
you
to
want
banning.
To match them when it comes to banning. It's just like that, that I'm sorry to quote this example, eating XYZ is bad, so you have to only eat this. I mean, who are you to decide whether I should eat A or should eat B? It's as simple as that. I mean, everything, ban everything, regulate it for heaven's sake. And also alternatively, please ensure that there are people educated to go and go for more adoption. But at the same time, you can't allow people to actually force the women inside the house to get into something which they don't want. I mean, there are going to be sister-in-laws, there are going to be so many other relatives which are going to be forced to do something which apparently they don't want, and then none of their interests is going to be taken care of. Mm. And later on, when the child is born out of that surrogate mother, I mean, there are other legalities which the child and the family may have to get into. So by
and
going,
the emotional attachment in
yes,
this case also
so many other
with the someone
so many
who's
things.
Carried a baby who is growing up yet in front of them in their sister-in-law's home.
Definitely.
Or
I mean, what this woman just now spoke, that she received only 1.5 and 50,000 was not given to, that is something that we need to take care of. I mean, multiple pregnancies.
And that is low-hanging fruit. It can
yes,
be if you cut down on
be.
It.
Yes.
So, Dr. Sheela Saravanan, explain this to me. I found that interesting. Sumita saying that she didn't have a good experience, yet she's saying she would do it again. Yet she's saying that she'd even do it again for free. You've spoken to so many women, you've heard all of these emotions, this gamut of emotions that they've probably been through. How do you explain this?
See, that's what we are not addressing, the stigma. Like, look at the, if you look at what she's saying, she's talking about social stigma, not only for the women who are, not able to bear the children, but the stigma that she faces as well.
But
stigma like any other surrogate mothers who are closing their face, they do face social stigma. That's one point. The other point that she's talking about
Ganga
is that...
Ganga says she doesn't care for what society thinks. Well, of course, she may be an exception, but go ahead.
No, most of the women actually do.
So the other thing that she talked about is that eating X and Y and other things, it's not as simple as that. So, because we have to see the broder picture that these women, their health and life is at risk.
A woman who is within the family, how are going to be taken care of?
So, their health and life is at risk. There are so many women, I mean, all of the 45 women that I met, they all have had some health impacts. Because this is artificial pregnancy that is created. The uterus lining has to be thickened through hormones. They are pumped hormones through 9 months.
But we're not banning IVF overall then.
No.
Are we?
See, I'm talking about surrogacy here now.
Yeah.
So when a woman becomes a surrogate mother, a poor woman who has substandard health in the first place, she is pumped with hormones, she is pumped with all kinds of medicines throughout her pregnancy, plus the extra trials that take her to this surrogacy in the first place. Are we not forgetting that it's not just as simple as eating X and Y? It is you're playing with somebody's body.
Okay.
And is that
okay? And I also want to talk about the whole criminalization of this whole procedure.
Do I have a right to do that?
Is that something you doctors are concerned with? Does this mean that you would even be worried about, maybe some doctors would be worried about even doing altruistic pregnancies or surrogacies?
Absolutely. The clause for criminalization is something which is so draconian that even if you make a clerical error in one document, it is a non-bailable offense. And the discussion in our society has gone to such an extent that even the leading surrogacy providers are now saying that if it is so, that even if a clerical error will be criminalized, we will never do surrogacy again. So this is something which is really the crux, and this kind of clerical errors being criminalized and all bailable offenses and all.
And
this
talk about
really
the fact that you must
be
having homosexual couples who come to you, same-sex couples who come to you, and they must have the same desires as I don't want to say regular couple, a male and a female couple wanting to have the same desire to have a child.
Absolutely.
What do you say to them? You turn them away?
They themselves, earlier people used to come, but since the time this bill got passed by Lok Sabha, I have several couples who call me on the phone and say, Dr. Gaur, we have to leave the country because there is no way that we can have a child here. Even if we have a child tomorrow, somebody will tell them you're an illegal child. So they simply have to make a decision to leave the country.
Wow, okay. Last word, Mamta, and then I want to go across to Ganga. Quick response to all of these issues that have been raised. This bill, very troubling on many fronts.
See, Sarah, I really want to make two, three quick points. Number one, the point which was raised that Indian families who in the families who the ladies are being taught or targeted, who cannot have their own biological kid by the family. But the same families do not even approve of surrogacy kids. A child having a child through surrogacy. There are lot of cases. Such cases exist in our own society. So that is also one thing. So even they are being taunted or targeted even after having a kid through surrogacy. Number one. Number two, if we talk about the child after surrogacy from their own relatives, you know, and we say there is a lot of emotional sentiments attached, which is quite obvious, Sarah. I feel that a lady who's otherwise also a surrogate will have that emotional attachment. All of us do. But if you are going for traditional surrogacy, you will definitely have that attachment, because then that surrogate is a biological mother of the child. Because in traditional surrogacy, the eggs are of the lady, of the surrogate mother. Okay, so
we are talking about a whole can of worms. I can't do that. I have one minute to show. I want to be factual and scientifically right. Surrogacy is just the womb.
If you have a gestational surrogacy where the egg and the sperms are of the parents or whoever or the donors, then obviously there is that emotional attachment here.
But I can't. We are out of time. Thank you so much, everyone. After the break, we're going to hear Ganga again, but this is We the People. We believe it's important to speak up, but it's also important to listen. And this is a debate we've gone ahead with tonight, despite all of the politics and the machinations going on in Maharashtra, because this is now going to be debated in Parliament this week. It is important that we are all aware and our parliamentarians are aware and take an informed decision. Yes, Mr. Since you're with the Rajya Sabha, last word.
Points that I want to make. Okay. One is expose the hypocrisy
of
saying that a woman can't sell part of her body. In India, we have the law of prostitution. Prostitution is legal. It's called suppression of immoral traffic.
Correct.
Which means that soliciting in public places is a crime. But selling your body is not a crime.
All right.
Here she is doing it.
There's still much more to debate on this. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Thank you and bye-bye.